One of the common things we hear is, what happens when my warm market is tapped out? Or, I feel I've reached out to everyone. Now what?
And I think one of the simplest ways to expand your warm market and break into new markets is the simple tool of hosting.
Mm-hmm. It's so true. Having others host classes for you enables you to spend your valuable time servicing your customers and training your leaders instead of constantly just inviting to classes. So who are these hosts and where the heck do you find them? Well, the first group of people are, number one, your friends and family. These are people that love you. They just love you and they want to support you. The second people are happy customers. Now, if you're just getting started, you may not have happy customers yet, and that's okay. They are coming. But for those of you that maybe you've been doing this a month or 2 months, you have some people that maybe they were a little bit skeptical about oils in the beginning, right? But now they're texting you some questions. They're loving their product. These are a great group of people that you can possibly engage a little bit further to expanding that information to people that they love and letting you teach them. The third group of people that are your potential hosts are people that are already in your classes. That doesn't mean that you know them. Maybe they were brought by a friend. But if you're already teaching classes, you are in front of people, and these are your potential hosts.
Perfect opportunity.
Yeah, it's true, right?
Yeah, each of these groups holds key to markets that literally open to you and that you are one step away from tapping into. So here's some great tips on how to ask each of these groups to host for you. Yeah. If you don't have a pen and paper, pause this video and go get it now because you're going to want these tips.
It's so true. Okay, so how in the world do I ask my friends and family now? Let's put some context here. These are people that love you. These are your friends and your family. Now, there are some friends and family that a simple text of, hey, would you like to host a class for me? Or I usually like the word workshop too. It's a little bit better than class. And some people, you know, can kind of get behind that and they know that it's gonna be more of an experience. But how to ask them, I have been very real with my friends and family, especially if I am, you know, trying to progress for something or I have a really big goal, I just pick up the phone. And I'm like, hey, girl, I know you love me, and here's what I need. Like, would you be willing to get five of your people in a room and let me do a workshop with them?
And it's worked, right?
It has totally. Guys, if these people, they love you, they want to support you. And so that's really big. And we have not because we asked not, right? Mm-hmm. And so a lot of times it's just getting past that fear of saying, hey, I need help.
And
will
not
you
dancing.
Help me?
Being
and not
super
dancing.
Honest,
just
like you're saying.
Just be real. Just be real. If they're your friends and family that love you, they want to know how they can come alongside and help you, which is really, really fun. Okay, your second group. How in the world do you reach out to happy customers? Well, what do your customers love? They love your product, right? And so one of the really cool
and accessories,
which is really fun because that's one of the really cool things that you can do with your customers is say, hey, I know you're loving your product and I have really appreciated watching you fall in love with these oils like I have. And so I wanted to call you and see, I have a couple spots available this month and I wanted to see if you would want to participate and really have the opportunity to earn some free product and some free accessories by hosting a workshop for me. It's super simple and it's just about getting 5 to 8 of your friends in a room. And literally, you would be so surprised how many of your customers would be excited to do this for you. They love your product. So an opportunity.
Love free stuff, right?
They love free stuff. So an opportunity to get something that they already love and are already paying for to maybe get a couple of those pieces of their collection they haven't gotten yet, or, you know, like she was saying, the accessories or the book to have a resource of how to use the product that they're already loving. You guys would be really, really shocked at how many people would chomp at the bit to do this with you and for you. It's been really, really fun to ask. So the third group, how in the world do you ask class attendees? Maybe these are attendees you don't know and that can feel a little bit, you know, uncomfortable, but your class is already set up beautifully for you to have an opportunity to actually ask them in class. So on the last page of your workshop guide, there's a little place that says live, share, and build. Right when you get to that share section of that last page, that's when you want to say, okay, for those of you, this is one way that you can partner with doTERRA. For those of you that are loving this information, but you have no idea how you would regurgitate everything I just said to your friends and family, this is where I would like you to invite me to come and share for you. And we have some really fun gifts for those of you that want to host a workshop. Another really great tip that I like to do, because sometimes at the end of a class, things are really crazy with getting order forms in, and you're not thinking about following up on that question, right? You mentioned it in class, but what about the follow-up at the end? So one of the great things that I've done is taken a post-it note and put it right on every order form. And it simply says, do you want to earn free oils? And that reminds me, when they turn in their order form, when they're purchasing something, that reminds me to say, oh, would you like the opportunity to earn some free oils by hosting a class? And I always have my calendar with me at every class. Another really great opportunity is when you guys are doing wellness consults. There's other training videos on how to do that. At the end of your wellness consults, I never complete a wellness consult without that last question. And also, would you like the opportunity to earn some free oils by hosting your own workshop? And literally allow the silence to happen. It's up to them to say yes or no. I don't want you filling that silence with some nervous verbiage, right? Like, it's okay if they say no, but they just might say yes.
And a lot of times we over-talk it, and then we don't give them a chance to actually answer.
You talk yourself right out of the cell or whatever it is you're trying to get.
Exactly. Yeah. So that's great ideas. And Faith, I know that you did something really super cool recently called Diamond Club. And it's a way in doTERRA that your leadership above you and even the company comes along behind of you, and they support you, and they actually get you on the road to build your business. And you've got selected to do that and to be a part of that. And so you have a ton of firsthand experience with how to support your host and how to make it super simple for them to host for you. So why don't you walk us through a little bit of what that sounds like?
Yeah, so the biggest thing is we want to support our host, right? We don't want this to be, you're not asking them to marry you or run a marathon for you. You're asking them to do something so simple, and we want to make it simple for you. You don't want to say, host a class for me, and then all this weight is on them. So you make it as simple as possible with these next three steps for your host. The first thing that you're going to do for your host is you're going to send them the script that they will send to their friends and family to invite people. Go ahead and write it out one time and just say, hey, you can edit this however you like. Put some emoticons in there, make it kind of fun. And if they don't want that, let them take it out, right? Yeah. But send them that script so that they don't even have to think about it, right? And encourage your hosts. Tell them, hey, it's a numbers game, right? Inviting 25 people, you'll get 10 to 15 yeses, and that's going to lend to about a 5 to 8 show rate. That's just the reality of this. Mm-hmm. It's a numbers game. Flat tires happen, weather happens, kids happen. It happens, right?
So, and this first step is so key, because so many people don't take the step of just taking that load, that first load off people in the invite. And then it sometimes doesn't happen, or it doesn't happen the way you would have done it. But it really comes down to, it's your fault. It's your business. It's your responsibility to equip them with something so simple. So take 5 minutes and prepare that email or text invite and get it to them right away.
It's so true, because a text can be very personal. Even though you're setting one and they're tailoring the name in and out of it for each person they send it to, it still feels personal. One thing that you want to be really careful, a lot of hosts will be like, oh yeah, they'll throw a Facebook event together and invite 500 people.
Don't do that.
When I am invited to something like that, I don't even pay attention to it, because I just feel like I'm one of 1,000 people. But if a text comes to me, or even a private Facebook message that has my name and, you know, certain things, that makes me feel like this person actually cares about me.
Right.
So really, really big, simple ways that you can help your host, and not telling them, but going ahead and doing it for them.
Mm-hmm.
So the second thing is, you want to text reminders 3 days out to your host, because here's the reality. You want your host to remind their guests or all of their confirmed people just 2 days from the event, and even the day of the event. guys, this is so simple. It's literally a text that's like, I can't wait to see you in a couple days. Or, and the day of, like, I get to see you tonight. Emoticon kissy face. I mean, you know, it's
it gives you a head count. It helps you to know, right?
Yes. And then that way, when you contact your host and you say, hey, how are we looking for tonight? Because I want to make sure I bring enough supplies for everyone attending. You know what you're walking into. You know how to be prepared mentally for who's going to be there or who's expected to be there, which is really great, okay? And it helps you... when you do reach out to your host, it helps alleviate some negative pressure that can come from, hey, how many people is coming tonight, you know? So it helps alleviate that as well. The third simple way that you can totally support your host is just by creating a simple shopping list. You may have watched the video where we talked about setting up an essential 101 class and the certain food items and like making sure you have paper cups and certain food items. Listen, that totals up to be about 6 items on a grocery shopping list. Super, super succinct and simple. Mm-hmm. So you may want to just text that to your host probably the week in advance and say, hey, these are not necessarily, but they're super fun additions to the workshop. Right. If you want to swing by this store and pick up these items right before I get there, about 5 minutes before I get there, I can just throw these oils in them really quick and it really makes for a powerful experience.
What you've just learned is an invaluable skill set that can transform your business in literally 1 month or less. Mm-hmm. Let this be fresh wind in your business. Sit down right now and do what Faith and I have done. Mm-hmm. Formulate a list of 30 potential hosts. Choose people from the 3 different groups that Faith mentioned to us and take action on reaching out to them this week.